Amish Tech Games 2016. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Groundhog Day, as I like to call it. This is my summer car. Okay, the lights just went out. The lights went out in Georgia. Oh, there's a storm a-brewing outside today. Oh, that's no bueno. Let's unplug that phone because, well, it's already unplugged. You'll notice the house is an absolute mess. I'm sorry, I didn't know I was having company over today. But no, honestly, last time I played was on the live stream. We went grocery shopping. Check all the beer we got out in here. Yeah, I got a lot of beer there. But we didn't do too much else. Oh, we did make some money. You'll see some money I've got. We made some money. Look at this. Storm's rolling in. With the truck, I pulled some cars out of barns. Well, one at least. And we took that down to Fieri's shop. So he should be good. I'm gonna call him Fieri. I think it's something else, but Guy Fieri, why not? Why not? So the sun is out and it's about to storm. What better day than this to tune our carburetor? We need to do that because the car is just ridiculously blowing black smoke out of the back of it. Oh shit, that was close. That was a real close one there. What happened to my freaking radio? This game loves to fuck with me, dude. It does. It likes to drop our radio down. Bruno Nimi. Nope. Oh, we can have ourselves a beer. Our thirst is looking pretty good there. Let's just throw it in the corner. Well, shit. We'll just throw it over here. But there's more beer over there. Shit, I forgot about that. Sledgehammer, you need to go back to the truck, dude. I don't want to forget you next time I go a-hunting. Let's try not to hold this up into the air and get, like, electrocuted or something. So we'll throw that in there. It's going to start pouring rain soon. I just know it. All right, so that's good. But, yeah, we had a real physics-breaking mishap in here. The car just completely randomly flipped upside down. So I had to fix it with that mesh save text. It was just ridiculous. It was absolutely ridiculous. And also, I do back the car in now instead of going straight in, because when I was backing up and we'd hit these little stupid things on the side, it was like make all these horrible noises. So backing it in, it just makes a little bit more sense to me. But yeah, since it's going to be a crappy day outside, shit, the electrical system is so bad here. Okay, it's back. That's pretty cool that they modeled that. That is actually really cool. But we blew a bunch of money that we made on stuff that we're probably going to need later on, which is, like, you know, coolant and all that good stuff. What we got here? We got a triangle in the Mac. I need my tools. There's my tools right there. Can I grab my tools? Yeah, I can. Oh, my God. It's not fucking around out there today. It is not fucking around out there. I'm glad we're going to be inside. Well, to say that our guy he's scared of the storms. I personally love thunderstorms. Oh, there's the rain. I knew it was going to come down. Okay, what else? Oh, yeah. The triangle needs to come out of there. I don't even know how the hell it got in there. There we go. Put that in there. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right. It's beautiful, Clark. Let's go ahead and open this. Nope. Open this. There we go. I'm going to remove these. I had the fuzzy dice in there, and they are fucking annoying as shit. Don't want to do it, dude. Oh, per dice. Got him. There they are, right there. Oh, yeah, I'll pull the handbrake. Why not? I don't want the car to roll into me. You know, that'd be really cool if they added that to where if you didn't set your handbrake and you're not working on the car, it rolls into you and it killed you. That would just be one more thing that people would not enjoy. I'm positive of that one. Let's pop the hood since we are going to be working on this baby. What we got here? Open the hood. Here it is here. We need to get this air filter off. So let's start with that. I believe that's a 6, right? I want to say it's a 6, but I could be wrong. Are you a 6? You are a 6. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Let's pull that out. There's 2 bolts here we got to worry about. Look at how sensitive my mouse is. My lord, man. All the way out you go. There we go. Very nice. Very nice there, eh? I don't know why I went Canadian on you. I'm sorry about that. Did not mean to. We'll pull that off just like that. Man, this electrical system. What would he say? He'd be pretty pissed off if the lights keep going off. He'd be like, we need to get that. One spring of pussies. Oh my lord. All right, cool. So let's go ahead and find the idle screw. I'm gonna go to tool mode here and grab our screwdriver here. And it should be right here at the front, right there. Okay, that one. And we want to unscrew this thing about 10 to 20 times. So we'll go to, I need to turn my mouse sensitivity down. Jeez, there we go. We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 18, 19, 20. Let's do, yeah, 20 is good for now to start with, to start with. All right, so that's good. And we did that. We need to pull the choke on the car next. Open you up. Open sesame. And the choke is right here. So let's go ahead and open that sucker all the way up like that. All right. And let's go ahead and start the engine up. What the shit? That wind come in here and knock that over? There's no way that it fell off on its own accord. That was strange. Well, you know what? This game's done some weird shit to me before in the past, so I wouldn't put it past it. I really wouldn't. Let's throw our tools there. All right. In we go. We should always be like, oh, hell for real. Yeah, I know, right, man? I know. We'll go ahead and go inner driving mode here. Let's make sure our pedals are working. Make sure our pedals are working. There's our clutch and our brake. Yeah, it looks pretty good, and that is set. Let's go ahead and hold the clutch in. We'll give it a couple pumps here. And start her up. There she goes. She came to life. Let's go up to about 3,500, 4,000 RPM, like they say there. And we want that temp to climb, and it is. We want to get there in the middle. In the middle range or so. Damn, that is the fastest climbing engine temperature I've ever seen. Like, when it's cold outside, well, it must be a pretty nice day, too. There we go. Engine temp looks pretty good there. Whoa, hello. Ooh, hello. That radiator is not liking that, is it? No, it is not. All right, so now we can close the choke, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it looks pretty good to me. So let's go ahead and close it. Close the choke. There we go. Engine temp looks pretty decent right there. It looks like it's not spiking or anything. But I don't know why that was shooting out. We had that problem on the live stream. And thank you guys for all of the support on the live streams. Been absolutely awesome working on this car with y'all. Somebody said that my radiator fan wasn't turning, but there's proof that it does work. I did do all that stuff right. What else we need to do? Oh, yeah. We need to check the exhaust smoke. We want this exhaust smoke to be much better than it is. That... it doesn't look bad. Could be better. Could be leaner. Could be leaner and meaner. Let's go ahead and pull this puppy right here. Want to check the smoke. What is the smoke looking like? That looks pretty dark to me. That looks pretty dark to me. Let's lean this baby out. Pull the adjustment screw out a little bit more. There it is right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That'll work. And let's pull it. How we looking back here? That looks pretty dark to me. Might need to lean it out even more. Ideal at mixture range. You can easily tell when you're in the range because the exhaust smoke turns a grayish white color. Yeah, well, we're not even close to that. Or maybe we're going too lean. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe that is the problem. Maybe we're going too rich, but I thought richer was the screw going in. It should be. Let's try this again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I just want to make sure because if we're not getting any better, then we're going the wrong way. And I'll just go 30 the other way because that'll put us back where we were. Or right around 30. I'm not being particular here. Get excited, bro. That looks pretty dark. Although, it does look like it's getting lighter, doesn't it? I don't know. It's really hard to tell. I have been tuning the hell out of this thing, and it's still black smoke. We're just going to go all the way back in, like 50 times forward. I'm going to try to make it richer and see if that does it. Richard, I'm 50. All right, I did 50 there forward. Let's see where this puts us. Whoa, that was a backfire. Oh, and that is white smoke. All right, so now we're getting somewhere, and it was backfiring, so that's rich. We need to go lean it out a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try that. Is that better? Oh, that looks perfect. I think we did it, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, so Going leaner made it blacker smoke. It's just trial and error, pretty much. But that looks really good and clear. That's almost got a little bit there, but nothing like it had before. And it's not backfiring. So I'm going to say that that's successful. I'm just going to say that one's a success. All right, let's go ahead and check our... Let's check our stuff. We'll take off the oil cap, and we'll top off our oil. We're going to do all of our fun stuff today. Let's grab you. Yep, you will work. You'll work just fine. And then we got to go take it for a test drive, of course. I mean, what kind of person would I be to not do that? I need to go like this. It's so weird how you have to do this. If they just gave you an option to spin it the other way. All right, how are we on oil? Oh, it was low. Got to top off your fuel, your fluids. Now, I've been having problems with the brakes. The brakes have been pretty bad lately. So we're going to go underneath the car and just double check the bolts. I'm pretty sure I didn't do that on the live stream and it was fine. So I'm thinking we need to bleed the brakes. I'm thinking that's what we need to do today. Let's bleed the brakes. Motor oil, you go over here. I wish I knew how much was left in them every time we use them. It's just hard to say which ones are empty and which ones are not. I guess you could just tell by holding it over there and hoping for the best. I assume that that is the case, but what do I know? All right, that's good. Let's go ahead and check our radiator fluid since we probably spewed some out during all of that nonsense. I'll tell you what. The entire times that I have worked on a car in my life, you know, I'm going to leave these on the shelf. We're going to use the ones that we have in the actual car from now on so I know when they're empty. That way we're not just using the same ones over and over again. That would be nice if they would let us know, but you know how they are. They're not like, no. You don't get to do that. All right, let's see here. Are you good? Let's just top our fluids off. That's what we're doing here. I think that was good. Yep, that looks... Looks pretty happy to me. All right, beautiful. Yeah, no more smoke everywhere. That is so nice. That is sure nice, I've got to say. No, open back up. Open back up, Sesame. I was grabbing that the coolant so I could flip it around where it'll actually just lay back there, but that's not easy, is it? No. All right, so that one's good. Beautiful. We'll check our brake fluid. Aha, it does tell you when they're empty. See how it says brake fluid empty? It's like, hey, that's good to know. I'm glad they actually tell you that it's empty so we can get a new one. That is awesome. So now we know when stuff is empty. It's like empty. It's like, well, all right. You don't want that to happen when you're out on the road and you need it. You know, that would be bad, but what? Oh, my Lord. It was low on fluid. Yes, it was. Come on. I think we need to bleed these brakes. I think that is the issue I'm having. But you know what? Low brake fluid, you wouldn't have brakes either. So it's hard to say. It's empty. That would be why. Okay, so the brake fluid doesn't... It goes pretty fast. We're going to have to remember that. My Lord. We have 3 empties of brake fluid. My God. Well, good thing I bought a bunch more. I got some from inside. I think this will be all right now. Oh, yep, there it was. Come on. Get on over there. There it goes. Yep, top her on off. That'll do. That'll do right there. Let's go ahead and put you back on. Let's check the rest of them. I think the other reservoirs should be all right. Well, we will definitely try and see if that is the case. Oh, my. They were very low. They were very low indeed. Come on. What? Is this thing empty already? No, it's not empty. This thing is just being a piece of shit. That's all there is to it. There you go. You got to get it just right. Come on. Come on. It's working now, but good Lord. It's empty. My God, these things are worthless. Brake fluid, brake fluid. Come on, all the way up to the top. Tippy top. What in the hell is going on with this thing? It just does not want to work. Bing! Topped off. But you... Well, I'm just going to check the last one. And it's full. Awesome. Beautiful. Well, I like to hear that. I do. All right, so we did that. Let's put the air filter back on and I go for a drive. Let's just go for... Oh, it's nice out now. Look, the storm has passed. The storm has passed. The sun is out. I can still hear the storm off in the distance, but hey. That is all right. Air filter on. Boom. Spanner 6, please. I need a spanner of 6. That'll do. And we can put these back in and make everybody happy. And we're going to go do a road test with the car, make sure that it doesn't stall or, you know, because I was having problems with it stalling. And that was just because the carb was not tuned at all. Other than that, I think everything else looks pretty honky-dory in here. So let's go and close you. Fantastic. I will take the tools with us because you know what? You never know. Come on. I just start spamming the F button anymore now when I'm near the toolbox because it's never right. It's like, no. Like, no, we're good. We're good on that. All right, that's all good and beautiful. Fuzzy Dice, you can stay. I don't care. I don't care about you anymore. All right, we'll go over here. Enter that driving mode. Close our door. The engine just sounds much better, you know? Handbrake is released. Let's see how she drives. Oh, much better. Much better. Look at that. I mean, it didn't stall at all on us. Like, at all. That's... Usually it bogs down and stuff right there. So, that's usually not good. Alright, let's, Thirst is looking meh. Hunger's pretty meh. We'll bring some beer with us because, you know what? That's just what you do in this game. You have to bring beer with you everywhere you go. We could be nice and open the door for ourselves, but you know what? Let's just use the power of physics that this game gives us. Dirtiness is looking meh. Let's put some skeeter spray on because you never know when that's gonna happen. Yep, just put that right there. And yeah, I think we're pretty close. Let's get something to eat real fast before we head out. We've got plenty of chips and sausages. Let's have some sausages and some chips. Sausage for me, sausage for you. Gone. Okay, awesome. Thirst. Let's just have a little bit of water before we roll out of here. Woo! Through the wall we go. Bam. Fatigue is just getting higher. Urine, we can always piss on the side of the road. Not really worried about that. We can close this. Yep, turn those off. Close that. I don't want any thieves. Even if the game doesn't have them in there yet, I don't trust them enough. I just don't trust them enough for that. All right, open you up. Beautiful. Let's go for a nice little drive together here. All right. Parking brake released. And let's go see how the alignment and all that stuff's doing too. We'll pull out of here like this. That's looking pretty good. Wow. It sounds like a brand new car, man. Let's see how she does at some higher RPMs. Get some speed up in the car. It does jot around a little bit. You see the play in the wheel there. That's just because of the alignment. So we need to do an episode where we go down to the drag strip and test the alignment. Hang on to her, beer. Okay, that don't know why that happened, but it was my shitty driving there did it. This thing kind of just pulls a certain way when you start getting to the edge of the road. It doesn't seem to like that, so yeah, you gotta stay on the actual gravel, Jeff. All right, let's do a brake test. Ooh, they are pretty much non-existent. Engine brake here. I'm pumping the brakes, as you can see here. Pumping the brakes. Oh my God. Pumping the brakes. They don't seem to be doing much. Where's the... Yeah, no. They are pretty bad. I think they need to be bled. Need to bleed them brakes, son. Let's head back home. 45 left, over jump, over crest. You can just feel how this car wants to become a rally machine. But with no brakes, you just kind of are out of luck. Oh, what? Like this. We're good. Just engine brake it. Pump them brakes, bro. Pump your brakes. Look at that. No brakes. Does it have to do S turns here to try to stop it? Oh my God. Oh, mosquitoes. Get out of here. Are those flies? He's a dirty bastard, so that's probably what they are. They're probably flies. They're probably flies. All right, we'll go over here. And I think that's pretty good. We'll back her in, of course. We will. And put her in reverse. I love the sound of the reverse gear. That's pretty cool. Nailed it. All right, right there. I'll be good. No brakes. I have a no brakes. Open that up. Let's go ahead and open up our garage door. Our garage door here. Open you. Not damaging the car. There we go. And we can back it back in where it was. Yeah, it needs some, definitely needs some work. That's for sure. The brakes definitely need to be bled. Having no brakes is just a bad, bad, bad all around experience. I won't even tell you the, you know, I don't have to tell you in this game, especially. That's going to be enough there. We'll just let it roll. Let it roll right there. Put it in neutral. Maybe a little bit more. Right there, it'll do. Perfect. Beautiful. Well, it didn't blow up or explode or anything like that, so that's always a good thing, right? Yeah, it is. Trust me when I say that. It is. All right. That came through the pack with all our off-roading. The jack decided to come out the back of the car. It needs to go sideways. Oh, that was, yeah, that was just beautiful. Yeah, let's just go through the engine. No problem. No probs. You know, I should just keep this in the back seat. I'm going to do that. It's just, it's so damn long that it needs to just be back there, I think, personally. Well, we did get something accomplished, and that was what I wanted to do by leaning the engine out and making it nice. In no more black smoke pouring out the back. We didn't even see any of it in the rear mirror. That is what it's all about. My guy's about to fall asleep here in a little while. Let's go ahead and close you. Nope, we'll close you. So next time, I think what we're going to do is we're going to probably make some more money by pulling cars out of the barns, as well as what else? I don't know if I want to do the firewood. I'll let you guys be up to that one. You want me to do the firewood missions? They look like they're kind of boring, but hey, you know what? I'm all ears. We'll go in here. We'll have some food. We'll have a piss. We'll sauna it up next time. I need to clean all this mess up, but I'm saving that for a live stream. Remember, I live stream my summer car on Fridays. If you want to join in on the fun at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time on twitch.tv/JFabiano. Link for that's always in the description. You can always check it out there. But with that said, guys, I will see you in the next one. Take care. Sleep. That's what you need, buddy. Oh, yeah.